On July 19th, 2019, we celebrated the 50th anniversary of the first human landing on the surface of the moon. And one of the very significant things that we discovered on that lunar landing, the first lunar landing, and verified it on all the subsequent Apollo landings, was that the surface of the moon is covered with very fine dust, like talcum powder. And what we discovered is that this fine talcum powdered dust that covers the whole surface of the moon, maybe down to 1 or 2 inches, is mostly glass-like, glass shards, and it created a lot of problems for the astronauts because it permeated their spacesuits, it permeated the habitat, and it turned out to be a very, very serious problem. We also didn't think we were going to send astronauts back to the moon. We thought the next aspect of human exploration would be the red planet, Mars. And now it was decided at high levels that we will go back to the moon. And that's why we're getting together at the Lunar and Planetary Institute in Houston, Texas in February to learn more about the dust, its characteristics and its properties, and then see what techniques or technologies can be applied to either mitigate or significantly reduce the dust problem during the next round of human exploration of the moon. One of our undergraduates at the College of William and Mary, Max Weinhold, has been working on a project to assess the impact of human activities on the future density and pressure of the moon's atmosphere. So what we're looking at in that study is how the atmosphere of the moon may respond to human presence and human activity, and then how that will impact the dust problem. Because the thicker the atmosphere, the more atmosphere there is, the longer the lifetime of the dust. So now we really have to consider this problem of lunar dust, and I am happy to say that some students at the College of William and Mary will have a unique opportunity to help NASA, to help the country in trying to solve this important issue that will affect future exploration of the moon.